Hello, Josef.
Hello. How are you feeling?
Feeling pretty good.
Good?
A little nervous, but that's with every show.
Same. You?
I'm feeling fabulous. As always. No, I'm just kidding.
Oh, this Zoom feature is just great.
Okay, well, the new one. They say, does anyone
Who's gonna do it? They're always the first to die.
Okay, well then I'm not doing it.
I'll do it, I'll do it, I'll do it.
You
go
ahead and die.
Alright, ready?
For someone to figure out that you were going to be away from home for a couple hours tonight.
enjoying a play at the local high school. Who knows what may be waiting for you at home? Did you remember to lock all the doors and close all the windows? The performance you are about to witness is psychologically as well as emotionally disturbing. People who have attended this gala before have complained about many unusual circumstances occurring after seeing this production. For those faint of heart, this is your last chance to leave. The spirits unlocked by Ouija still linger in these walls as we speak. However, you might be safer in here than out there, in the wide open.
Oh, come on. Are you sure that the party's here?
Half. It says 18. One of us to add. That's the house number. We're here.
You're kidding.
No.
Yeah, you are.
What? I don't know how I feel about this anymore. This is lame already. Come on, let's just go.
Oh, come on. I mean, look at the house. Looks like no one's lived in it for years.
Oh, they definitely decorated it that way.
Let's go. We're going in.
Why?
Let's go!
This is not funny!
Are you kidding me?
Wait, that flashlight doesn't work!
Ugh.
Just...
what is this?
Was that really necessary?
Yeah, it really was.
Where is everyone?
Rachel! Where are you?
I feel like we're in a freaking horror movie.
Rachel!
What was that?
What? What was what? What was what? What was what? What?
Oh, we gotta leave.
No, we're not leaving. We just got here.
You know, do you see that?
What is it? What?
Look out the window. Someone's standing out there. Screw this out of my
head. No, come on. I gotta call Rachel. Stop. Get back in the house.
Watch the hideous thing. uncoil from the shadows. As your hearts start to race, even though your legs refuse to. If you felt time slow as the creature crosses the ring in the darkness of a blink. Have you shuddered as the clawed hand is placed on top of your head and under your chin so it can tilt it, exposing your neck? Have you squirmed as its rough, dry tongue slides down your cheek, over your jaw, to your throat in a slithering search seeking your artery? Have you felt its hot breath release a hiss against your skin when it probes your pulse, the flow that leads to your brain? Has its tongue rested there, throbbing slightly, as if savoring the moment? Have you experienced a sinking, sucking blackness as you discover that not all vampires feed on blood? Some feed on memories.
Well, let me rephrase the question. Have you ever walked into a room and suddenly forgotten why you came in?
Stays with Cori until he falls asleep. Reads every night her favorite bedtime story. back of the pond to a nearby tree. She hits the gas again. She hears a loud scream. When she gets out of the car, she sees her boyfriend hanging from the tree. The loud noises with a squeaking of his shoes against the top of the car.
Jess! Jess, I need you! Am I
pretty now.
Oh my god. Jeff, you were right! No one can!
I can make you pretty. Just like me.
Please don't hurt me! I didn't do anything wrong! Jeff, come back! Please don't stop!
We'll hospitalize her and keep her heavily medicated for the next couple of weeks, the doctor said. That should help her get through this. Sure enough, about 2 weeks later, the Hillary crawled out of the woman's ear. The husband was at his wife's bedside when the tiny creature appeared. He grabbed it and put it in an empty water bottle. The next day, the couple, with the earwig in the bottle, sat down with the doctor for a final examination. Let's get another set of x-rays, the doctor said. It took a little longer for the film to return. When the x-rays finally arrived, the woman, the husband, and the doctor all assembled in his office once more. I'm afraid I have to modify my diagnosis, said the doctor. I've examined the earwig and the x-rays. Took a deep breath. This was a female. They must have been pregnant and crawled into your ear. It's laid its eggs, and when they hatch, they will devour your brain.
Don't know how long this will last.
All right. Thank you, doctor, for diagnosing him so quickly.
Gathered here today to celebrate the life of Mrs. Octavia Smith Hodge, who was taken from us too soon. Octavia was a well-read, articulate lady, as many people have commented. She was an interesting woman to listen and talk to, someone who could understand and appreciate your personal point of view. Octavia, I'm sure, counted herself lucky to have such a caring and loving husband to help nurse and care for her as her condition deteriorated. And I'm also sure she gained a great deal of comfort from knowing he was there for her, as she had great trust for him. And all we can do now is offer comfort to Mr. Hedger and hope that she's in a better place. Thank you for coming. And there will be a reception at Mr. Hedger's residence immediately following the ceremony.
existing heat.
It's been such a very, very long time. Maybe your sister-in-law would be kind enough to share some of your favorite food options. She's due any minute. Oh, Miss Reynolds, we were just talking about you.
Oh my God, you were? I mean, both of you?
I'm sorry. No. I was just talking to Bernard about you. We were just discussing many options. He still refuses to eat.
I can't imagine why. If I were in his shoes, I'd be ravenous.
I know. He's been without food for such a long time. Maybe if we were patient,
Doctor. Maybe.
What? What is it?
I brought this from home. It was taken to Bernard and my sister at their wedding. 2 days before the accident, I thought maybe if we showed it to him, it would get him to talk, to cry, to show some sort of emotion. I just can't stand to see him. They were so happy.
Well, I can't see any harm in it. Bernard? Bernard!
And then what?
And then he'll become a teacher.
A teacher? It's a noble profession. audition is a guaranteed trip to the poorhouse, Jenny. He'll be a bum with a college education. His student loans and your expensive tastes.
We thought you could just help us out.
I'm not a charity. He can find someone else to leech off of. That boy has never committed himself to anything, least of all to you, Jenny.
Mother, he asked me to marry him.
That's out of the question.
I'm not asking you, I'm telling you.
And I'm telling you! Little Jenny, with her head in the clouds. If I didn't even see you with him, you will no longer be my daughter.
I'd like to marry your daughter, maybe.
My dead bar.
If that's what it takes.
My mother was a very wealthy woman. Jenny and I didn't know what it felt like to want or need anything. We didn't know what it meant to have to work. My sister was left with a difficult choice. Stay committed to the man she loved and lose her mother with all of the luxuries she had become accustomed to. Or stay with Bernard and hope, or leave Bernard and hope to find someone mother approved of. She chose Bernard. Didn't last long.
Hauss, the most beautiful woman in all the world.
What? Oh, did you get the groceries?
No.
Bernard, we need food. Things to eat, it's a necessity.
I know. There are things in the cupboard, right?
We had the last hamburger last night, and these are the last two potatoes. Which I mentioned to you last night when we had potatoes. Which I mentioned the night before that when we also had potatoes. I'm so sick of potatoes.
But they're cheap.
Because they taste like dirt.
Not if you put salt on them. We'll be eating filet mignon once I get signed on as a teacher.
You have been saying that for the past 6 months. It's time to find a job.
I'm looking.
I'm hungry, and I can assume you are too. And we can't keep living like this. We need food to survive.
I don't need to eat.
What?
You can help mine.
Don't be ridiculous.
I've been saying that as long as I've got love, I don't need anything else. And as soon as I come home and see you standing there, it's been all about me.
Mark, I send you with some money. Why don't you just buy groceries?
I got something better.
You mean you spent the last of our cash?
Yes.
I thought you just forgot. I didn't realize you spent the last of our money. A piece of garbage you can buy me this time. Another wind chime to lull me to sleep with? Or let me guess, another puppy I'll fall in love with. I'm going to have to return it to the MSPCA when we realize we can't afford to feed it anymore.
I don't understand.
My mother was right. You are a loser.
It's a cold wedding, man. Now, I know that you're not happy with wearing this up, eating this food. And I know that we can't afford to get married right now, but honestly, I feel that we already have. Now, I wanted to get you something real, something you'd be proud to show off to people.
Jenny apologized to Mother, and she took her baby girl back. But I never forbade her from the way she treated Bernard. He would write letters to her weekly, with no return address so that Mother would catch on. Beautiful letters of love and hope. Jenny let me read some. He always signed them, "Until we can be together." Mine was the only thing that would happen would be if Bernard found a job. Mother died. Jenny went back for 2 years. And then she met someone new. She got married, moved away. The letters kept coming. It was just too sad. I stopped reading them. Even though Jenny wasn't writing back, he was never angry or hurt. He just remained faithful that one day they would be together again. He wrote to her for 20 years. 20 years! And in all that time, I never saw Bernard. None of us did. Not until Mother's funeral. She had a heart attack and died in her sleep. Bernard? Bernard, Sal? Is that you?
Chloe.
Remember me.
How could I forget Jenny's little sister?
Her only little sister. How have you been?
Fine.
Teaching?
I'm a professor now.
Really? Wow, that's really great. Married?
No, why would I be married?
Oh, well, I thought...
I better get going. It was nice seeing you, Chloe.
What's it been? Like 20 years?
21, actually.
I'll call her over.
I'd rather be alone.
Why not?
Her husband is here.
Oh. You heard about Frank.
What's he like?
You want to know the truth? Or do you want to know what I tell people when I'm trying to be nice?
The truth it sounds about more intriguing.
Okay? He's a drunk. A worthless drunk. Mother set him up and lived to regret it. You know, in the last year, she'd ask about you.
Really?
Yeah. She'd say, I wonder what that sap kid is up to. At least he was too poor to get drunk like Frank. No, Bernard, please freeze right there.
Jenny. Funny seeing you here.
Frank, how odd for me to be at my mother's funeral.
I'm sorry. For your loss.
No, I'm not sorry.
So tell me about you. Married, I hear?
Yes.
Kids?
No. Frank didn't think it'd be a good idea to have kids.
Why?
He just didn't. I went back to school. I became a nurse.
Good for you. Sorry to hurt you.
No. No. There was something.
There isn't. What's wrong?
Norm, please, I'm fine. Just stay out of this, please.
I take you.
Stop, please. Norm.
Hey, Jenny, how much longer are you going to make me stand out here with these jerks? I'm bored.
Frank, I need a little more time. I'm not ready to go.
Time to do what?
Frank, we just buried my mother.
Yeah?
Yeah? All you can say is yeah?
Well, she was 86. How much longer did you really want her to live?
Frank, that's not the point. I needed more time.
I said I wanted to go!
No.
No? She didn't make me drag her. Why do you always make me do this?
Stop!
Go! Let go of her, Frank!
Frank, stay out of this, please!
Bernard Sack.
Well, shut up!
Just go home, Frank. Just go home.
What's it to you?
Just go home, please.
I love you. I love her.
A real Shakespearean tragedy.
When he was found on that lifeboat, he was in a deep state of shock. We may never see the Bernard you knew or admired, but don't let that ruin how happy he made your sister. His words don't mean anything to us. Probably don't mean anything to him. He's just lucky to be alive. 45 days on a lifeboat with no food, only drinks from the plane's beverage compartment. How could he survive? I don't know, Chloe. None of us know what happened out there. Only Bernard knows for sure. Maybe you should go. I can see this is upsetting you. Wait.
Or perhaps under your children's beds.